out of San Diego, Kade Ruotolo, the lightweight submission grappling world title against Uali Kurzhev tomorrow night as they go nose to nose. No love loss right here.
Kade Ruotolo! Uali Kurzhev!
These are my commands. Shake hands if you want to shake. Stepping back.
Lightweight submission grappling world title on the line here in ONE Championship as we make history here tonight. Kade Ruotolo and Uali Kurzhev. Kurzhev cannot win the title. He did not make weight, but Kade Ruotolo, the
Judge.
American superstar,
Judge.
Has Bye, an opportunity That's right fight. Here to take home a world title and become the next American superstar in all of sports, Mitch Chilson.
Yeah, let's see how he enters into this takedown. Like you said, ooh, nice little sweep right there. Ooh, Uali, as they start immediately hand fighting and looking for their grips.
Yeah, you can see Wally's frame and strength right away on this.
Yeah, we got to clinch up in the back and play around a little bit. I thought he was going to toss me through the wall. Nice little back take there by Kade Ruotolo.
He's got the back. Ruotolo does. 1 10-minute round here.
And this was off of an attempted throw by Uali.
Yeah, Uali's trying to fight one hook. Kade still got the back. Nice little drag to the mat right there from Kade Ruotolo. He sneaks one hook in. Let's see if he can get the other one. Uali's going to try to turn into him. Might end up in mount here. Good adjustment from Kade to maintain back position.
Whoever gets the submission wins the fight. If it goes the full 10 minutes, it's whoever had the most legitimate attempts. So neither fighter wasting any kind of time here.
Yeah, Kade started to attack there, looking for a Sulaev stretch. But he's going to try to flatten him out here, possibly go hunting for a neck. Uali's got the right hand of Kade, and Kade's trying to free that arm, but Uali's got good grips. He might be able to pop that right hand out, though. There he does.
He's got to be careful that he doesn't get too far sideways here, allowing Uali to, he's corrected himself and got back to the top again.
This is what we saw from Kade in his debut against Shinya. He has really good back control as he applies hip pressure to flatten out Uali.
Set it up.
What's Kade setting up here? What's he trying to get?
Now he's got both hands free. Now he's looking to go underneath the neck.
There you go.
Yep.
Perfect.
Cross face right there. Perfect. He's applying a rear naked choke. But Uali's got good defense from this position. He can fight those hands. Kade has expressed that he does have MMA ambitions. He wants to transition and go for multiple sports, but right now he's looking really strong with his back position.
We also got the buggy from the back.
You can hear his brother Ty calling out. He's got the buggy choke from the back.
Yep.
Twin brother Ty is a sensation in his own right. Uali Kurzhev also has a twin brother who's at the highest of these levels.
He's got an arm triangle here. Looks like he's going for his signature Darce choke finish. Let's see if Uali can peel this hand off the head. Uali's tough. He's going
to
fight that hand.
Lock it in here.
This is where Kade's 76-inch reach comes in into advantage. Being able to work from these Darce chokes, anaconda chokes, rear naked chokes.
Kade's got a similar reach to like Michael Phelps. Those arms are just so long.
5-inch advantage.
Rear naked choke's under. He's right above us. Let's see if he can wrap things up here.
He's not under the chin yet.
Squeeze the body like a backpack here. Just 3 minutes in. Uali Kurzhev gets taken down by Kade. Kade on his
nice slam right there to end up on top position. But Kade threatens the triangle, goes on a pata, and Uali chooses to run away.
Nice escape there by Uali Kurzhev as he brings the fans into play.
That was good, but those are some submission attempts. I wonder if they're going to count for catches.
What I like about the fact that when Kade hit the ground, as he was going down, he was already looking for a submission. And as Uali was backing away, he was still looking for things to grab, something to clip onto to earn that takedown, or at least just get him out of position like he did with Shinya when he did that low ankle pick.
Good snap downs early by Kade. He's trying to disrupt the balance here and the posture of Uali Kurzhev. He's inside.
Excellent. Excellent.
Disengage. Touch guard. He's doing a good job of fighting the head position of Kade, but Kade's able to snatch up a single, goes to the body lock, ducks underneath, takes the back up. Uali's trying to roll through.
finishes her leg there.
Good action from both men in the opening half of this 10-minute fight. One round.
Kade's going for a leg. So Kade's passing the guard there, but he's already positioned the leg for the heel hook.
And there he is on the heel hook. Well, he's doing a good job of fighting the hands. First thing he has to do is fight those hands, but he's got to get it.
It's over. Heel hook. Kade Ruotolo gets it done.
And that was completely set up from the guard pass. Kade was already looking for that from the guard pass. You saw it.
He was in complete control of that fight. Just kept trying different things, showing all of his techniques, and it ends here with a submission victory for the 19-year-old American.
Kade Ruotolo!
Kade Ruotolo takes home the belt here tonight in Malaysia. The lightweight submission grappling world champion. And the first ever here in one championship for Ruotolo, the American from San Diego, with the winner. The Dragon is standing by.
Kade Ruotolo, 19 years old, two world championships in just over 1 month. My friend, how are you getting things done so early on?
Man, to be honest, I think it's just 16 years of preparation, man, my entire life. I've been doing this since I could remember, you know, and I was bored on these mats, so it was just a matter of time until the results started paying off.
Well, it definitely showed the way you were attacking. Once you got that leg, did you know that was a wrap?
Guaranteed. Once I got that my free leg over and I seen his heel kind of poking out, I was like, oh, it's right there. I got it for sure. As soon as I lashed it on, man, props to him. He's so tough. He let it pop multiple times. It was kind of nasty. I make sure to check up on him, make sure he was good. But, man, he's a stud. He's an absolute monster for sure. That foot sweep in the beginning, man, caught me by surprise. I wasn't ready for that. Legend.
Well, walk us through this because some of the people here in the Axiata Arena might have missed it. So take a look up here at the big screen and tell us what's going on.
Right. So from there, I just entered into a leg lock situation, the inside heel hook. From there, man, it's so hard to defend. Once you get that grip, I'm putting my hips in, all the pressure's on the inside of his knee. And then right there, you see his torquing, nasty. I get as much leverage as I can. And like I said, it popped maybe 3, 4, 5 times. And I was like, how is this? He's got rubber legs, I think. It wasn't even human, but finally got the submission, stoked.
I don't know, but I might have to start calling you King Midas because everything you're touching is turning to gold. I got some more gold for you. How about $50,000 from Chachri Sidyatong to celebrate your win?
So stoked. Man, my brother and I, we're building a gym out in Costa Rica right now. We're kind of putting everything we got into it, and that literally just finished it, bro. I'm lost for words. Thank you so much, Chachri, everyone behind one. I'm so stoked. Beyond thankful. Thank you so much. The gym's done, Rada. The gym's done.
Well, you're on an incredible roll. What's next for the one lightweight submission grappling champion?
I believe, I think December, you guys have another show, if I'm not mistaken. I'm not sure if that's for sure yet, but man, just the sooner we can get back in here to the circle, the better. You know, I want to go ahead and defend my title ASAP. I got a couple of names on the mind, if you don't mind me calling them out. They both start with T, so Tynan Dalbra and Tommy Lankaker. Both of those matches will be insane. I know both those guys are signed to one, and if we could get it going at the end of the year, I would love those matches for sure. We need to get it going.
Either way, we would love to see that fight. Can't wait to see you guys back. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for the new one lightweight submission grappling champion, Kade Ruotolo!
He told us this week